is Marissa Morales.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie Bender.
And I'm Madison Soto, and we're doing the endocrine body system for our case study.
CBN861 is starting his period and frequent urination causing dysuria, nausea, and migraines. He suffers from disrupted sleep causing insomnia. He believes that he's coming down with a common cold and decided to go see his regular physician. Before being seen by the physician, the nurse takes his vitals and sees an unusual drop in his blood pressure of 140 over 90, resulting in hypertension, tachycardia of 100 beats per minute, a slight fever of 99.8, and tachypnea with a respiration rate of 20 breaths per minute.
While the physician is conducting the examination, Stephen then explains that he is suffering from vision problems. He also explains that he has problems with erectile dysfunction. Worried about these extra symptoms and determining it is not just a common cold, the physician orders Stephen to have an MRI conducted to see what is causing the MRIs and nausea. After receiving the results, the physician notices a benign tumor. The doctor diagnoses Stephen with a pituitary adenoma.
The doctor then further explains that the cause for this is currently unknown and says to Stephen that it might be inherited. He explains that the side effects of not treating this could be damage on the optic nerve and on the brain. He then explains the treatments for this, which are two surgeries, which is a craniotomy and a endoscopic transnasal transphenoidal approach. Stephen decides to choose the endoscopic transnasal transphenoidal approach. After the surgery, it takes about 1 week for the surgical sutures to heal, fully heal, and it takes about another 2 weeks for Stephen to return back to work post-operation.